So maybe you got dumped, but for you, it's not yet over. You want your ex back, and you're doing everything in your power to make them change their mind. Now, I admire your drive, but really, you're going about it all wrong. The truth is, if you really want your ex back, what you need to do is stop chasing them completely. Hi guys, I'm Brad Browning, author of The X Factor Guide. And as a lifelong breakup coach, I've helped thousands of people like you get a second chance with their ex. Now, oftentimes the second chance turns into a long-lasting relationship, a marriage, and even more. But let's take this one step at a time. First, I'd appreciate it if you'd like this video and then subscribe to my channel as well. But now let's talk about why you're chasing after your ex. Now, I'm sure that right now you feel lost and alone. You just want the pain to be over, and you think that the best way to make that happen is to reconnect with your ex, figure out what went wrong, and reconcile. You know, maybe you think that the more time went by, the less chance you have with them. And that's what's driving you to do some pretty crazy things like, you know, calling them repeatedly, blowing up their phone with texts, and maybe even showing up out of the blue to surprise them. Well, I'm here to tell you that you've already made some serious mistakes here based on bad assumptions. And if you don't pull back right now, you might just lose your ex forever. First off, let's talk about the first assumption, that the best way for you to feel better right now is to win back your ex. Now, I think this is actually probably dead wrong. I'm not saying this shouldn't be your goal in the long term. I think there's plenty of relationships that can be rebuilt stronger than ever and lead to many years of happiness for both parties. But in this moment, trying to reconcile with your ex is only going to cause you more pain and heartbreak. And in reality, removing your bad feelings is not a good reason to get back together with your ex. And if you do go in with this mindset, you're going to end up right back where you started, whether it's in another few days or weeks. Right now, what you need and what your ex needs is time and space. So whatever went down between you two was obviously significant enough to cause them to dump you, or at least for you to agree to go your separate ways. And you both need to sit with the implications of that and process what went wrong. Now, I know it's painful, but unless you get to the root of what really went wrong in the relationship, you'll never reach the path forward with your ex. Now, this time apart is not only for your own mental well-being, it's necessary to make your ex realize that they made a mistake, and it's essential to getting that second chance. And remember that this time apart is not forever, though it may feel that way. As you know, I'm a big proponent of the no contact method. That's where you basically spend 30 days after the breakup completely cut off from your ex. No calls, no texts, no in-person meetups, nothing if possible. And you don't need to ignore them completely, but don't get dragged into a conversation and don't let them use you as a shoulder to cry on in hopes that it'll lead to something more, because it won't. Now, for more info about no contact, check the description below. I'll include some links to my other past videos. But essentially, it works by giving the two of you some time apart. Now, this time apart has a few functions. First, it allows you to process the negative feelings that are associated with the breakup. I mean, I'm sure if you two met up right now, it could easily turn into a shouting match where you'd say things that you regret and drive a wedge even deeper into things. After 30 days, some of that negativity that you've been stuck in is going to fade from your ex's mind, and he or she will be much more open to talking with you in a calm and constructive manner. Second, it makes your ex worry about losing you. Now, this time apart will hammer home the idea that they really will have to live without you. If you're always showing up and reaching out to them, they won't have time to miss you or really even notice your absence. So in order to maximize this feeling of loss, try to spend some time dating new people. I know dating new people is probably the furthest thing from your mind right now, but it really can help you in the long run. It'll give you an added confidence boost, seeing that you do have other options, and it will make your ex jealous and upset, which will definitely help your chances big time. Now, I know it's hard to actively make choices that might hurt your ex. You know, after all, you care about this person. But this is the kind of wake-up call that will make the difference between staying single and reconnecting with your ex for good. And essentially, since they probably broke up with you, you're giving them exactly what they've asked for. They can't begrudge you moving on after being dumped. Third, no contact allows you some time to work on yourself. Now, self-improvement is the best way to spend your no contact period, because without your ex, you know, you're going to have more time on your hands. You could either spend that time wallowing in sadness and, you know, end up 10 pounds heavier, full of regret and cut off from the world, or you can spend it making small but meaningful changes in your life that will not only make you feel better, but will show your ex that you're someone who's working towards goals and making the most of their life. And this will create a powerful contrast to the puddle of tears they left you in when they decided to end things 30 days ago. And really, whatever happens next, this will have been time well spent, because it will show you that you don't need them to be happy after all. And if you can understand this, you'll realize your value, and when the time comes to reconnect, you'll be more confident and in control. And finally, a no-contact period subverts your ex's expectations. So instead of, you know, chasing after them like they expect you to, you're taking the initiative to move on with your life, improve yourself, and disconnect from them completely. Now, this sends a powerful message that they're not the winner and you're not the loser. They won't have you begging for forgiveness or trying to change their mind. They'll just have to live with their decision and watch as you live your best life without them. So if you can't contact your ex, how are you supposed to know what your chances are of getting them back? Well, you're in luck because you can just head over to breakupbrad.com/quiz right now to take my free ex-back quiz. It just takes a few minutes, it's totally confidential, and it gives you a personalized report that lays out exactly how likely it is that you can have a second chance with your ex. Again, you can find that at breakupbrad.com/quiz. Let's talk about the question that I'm always asked about no contact. What if they forget about me? What if this time apart causes them to realize that they made the right choice and allows them to move on? Well, in my experience, it's extremely rare that your ex will just forget about you in 30 days. In fact, it's actually around the 30-day mark that they'll begin to miss you more than ever, because that's when it dawns on them that they may really have lost you forever. And coinciding with that, it takes about 30 days for their negative feelings surrounding the breakup to kind of fade away, so that when you do contact them, they'll be much more open to talking with you. And while this time apart will allow them to process the breakup, this is actually a good thing. You know, it's not going to mean that they're going to suddenly realize how much they didn't like you. It's almost always the opposite. When someone handles a breakup gracefully, it makes the dumper think, wow, they're handling this so well. Maybe I was wrong about them. Maybe I made a mistake. And letting them really sit with that feeling will be key to winning their heart again. So we've talked about why no contact works. Now let's talk about why chasing your ex doesn't work. Now this applies to chasing your ex in any way, whether you're demanding an explanation, begging them to take you back, or just staying present in their life in hopes that they'll realize their mistake that they've made. And it's all bad news, and here's why. Chasing your ex sends them the wrong message. Now, I know that the message you're trying to send is this: I want you back, I think we can make this work if we can give it another try, and I'm the perfect person for you. But the message you're actually sending by doing that is quite different. By chasing your ex after being dumped, you're telling them that you lack confidence in your own desirability, that they're the desirable one, and that you're lost without them. So think about it this way. Have you ever turned someone down romantically? Has that person ever stuck around refusing to take no for an answer, pathetically trying to get your attention and make you change your mind? Well, this never works because it only makes you feel more desirable and it makes them look more desperate and low status. And that's exactly what you're doing to your ex right now. And by chasing your ex, you're also telling them that you don't respect their feelings or their boundaries. Breaking up with someone is never easy, right? It took a lot of reflection for them to come to this decision, and it required a lot of courage for them to go through with it. Because at the end of the day, they do still care about you a lot. They even still probably love you on some level. So for them to dump you and for you to refuse to accept that decision and keep on hanging around, trying to change their mind, that sends the message that you think your wants and needs outweigh theirs. And if you don't respect their decision, it's pretty easy to see that you don't respect them as an individual who's made a choice. And this isn't romantic or charming, it's hurtful and it will hurt their opinion of you. Not only that, but chasing your ex actually has the effect of strengthening their resolve. The more you try to reach out to them and try to get their attention at this point, the more they're going to pull away. This is just simple human psychology. They're trying to protect themselves because that they know that they do love and care about you, so if they let their guard down, you just might be able to change their mind. So knowing this, every move you make in their direction, they're going to put up boundaries and walls to try to keep you away. If you break through those barriers by, you know, stalking them, showing up at their work, or otherwise pestering them, you're only going to make them feel scared and unsafe, which is not what you're going for. So at the end of the day, if you want your ex back, then you need to stop chasing them for now. I know it might be difficult. It might feel like you're going against every fiber of your being, but you need to trust me that no contact is the best way forward. As a breakup coach, I've helped thousands of people around the world get the second chance that you're looking for, and it's always through careful planning, restraint, and subtlety. It's never from sending them, you know, 400 texts at 3 a.m. Well, that just about does it for this video. Thank you for watching all the way to the end, and I wish you the best with your ex moving forward. If you found any of this video helpful, don't forget to like it and subscribe to my channel. I recently passed 500,000 subscribers, which I never thought would be possible here on YouTube, so thank you for that. And also, please don't forget to follow me on Instagram. My handle is @BreakupBradBrowning if you want to check me out on there. That's it for this one. Bye for now, and I will see you in the next video.